the Wright family, missionaries to the country of Greenland. On July of 2018, my family and I moved 200 miles north of the Arctic Circle to the town of Ilulissat to work with an independent Baptist missionary and his family. The Scholls have an established Baptist church that the government of Greenland recognizes. The only possible way one can live in Greenland is by a work contract permit. We currently meet that obligation by serving in the ministries of the Ilulissat Baptist Church. We participate in the kids club, jail ministry, and music ministry of the church. This past year and a half, we have learned much from their experience and input. We appreciate them opening up their ministry to us and allowing us to serve along with them in Greenland. The first few months we were here were filled with the experience of looking for housing. Ilulissat is a tourist town, so housing is limited and very expensive. We lived in limited space at the church while waiting for something to open up. And without any permanent housing, we had no place for our belongings to go. So in the course of 2 months, we loaded and unloaded our container 3 different times. Needless to say, we were excited that apartment finally opened up for us on August the 28th. Without a vehicle, we quickly learned our way around town, walking everywhere we needed to go. And after 4 months, the Lord provided us a means of transportation. What a blessing to be able to drive our groceries home. We've made it through our first winter in Greenland. We've experienced firsthand the 24 hours of darkness and thankfully a mild winter. We've enjoyed seeing how Greenlanders celebrate Christmas. Their celebration begins early in December with the arrival of Santa on a dog sled for the lighting of the town tree. With no firework restrictions in Greenland, the new year turned into quite the spectacle for us. One of the highlights of this past year was the dog sled race in March. It was the largest gathering we had seen in the town. Each town has an annual sled race, and the winners from each town move on to the national race finals. On June the 21st, we had the opportunity to experience Greenland's National Day. It is like our 4th of July in America. It is a celebration on the longest day of the year to celebrate Greenland's culture. It was a day that was filled with many Greenlandic activities such as a seal hunt, native costume dances, folk dancing, and a march with the flags. Greenlanders proudly fly their flag at almost every home. Our summer months were filled with the gospel boat repairs. The gospel boat is a ministry of the Ilulissat Baptist Church that takes the gospel to nearby villages. I installed 2 motors in the boat. This was quite the experience since the motors and all of the parts had to be shipped in. With no shop, we improvised using a 20-foot container to work in. Lighting, cleanliness, and waiting on parts were many of the issues we faced. However, we were able to run both engines before installing them in the boat. Our goal has been to build relationships, to learn the language, and to reach Greenland with the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is a slow and difficult task. The Greenlandic language is our toughest challenge. There is limited information and study helps about the language in English. However, just about anything I want to know about the language is available in Danish. So we're learning Danish along with the Greenlandic. I am progressing in Danish and have been teaching chronological Bible studies in Danish once a month. Greenland is 3 times the size of Texas with a population of over 55,000 that are spread in 73 different towns and villages. There's currently only 1 Baptist church in the entire country of Greenland. Our ultimate desire is to see Greenlanders saved, baptized, and discipled with a church plant in another town. We have recently learned that a church plant in another town will not be possible until we obtain permanent residency. This is a process that will take 6 consecutive years of living and working in Greenland. We are praying that somehow this process can be sped up. Jesus expressed the same desire to his disciples in Mark 1:38 when he told them, "Let us go to the next towns that I may preach there also." Would you prayerfully consider your part in reaching Greenland with the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ? Will you pray? Would you give? And would you be willing to go? Thank you for your faithful support in prayers and finances that have allowed us to serve God in Greenland.